So here we are at Auto Armor of Asheville. What we're going to be doing is a little tutorial today on how to install your the vinyl wrap kit for your BMW panniers. So we've got, you can see we've got the patterns laid out. We've got our panniers, and really all you need just an alcohol solution, as well as your installation squeegee and microfiber towel. So we'll get set up here. The first thing you're going to want to do is go ahead and just clean off that pannier, whether it's brand new, whether it's new or used. Just spray a little bit of alcohol solution on, wipe it down. If you've got stickers or anything already on there, you want to get the stickers off. That's good, because this will show, actually the stickers will show through, leave an outline. But the same technique we use on this first piece of luggage is the same you'll use on all of them, and it's just a matter of just recognizing the pieces, lining the pieces up, and laying them down. The film that we use is a 3M 1080 control tack film. Some of the other special colors that we have, or if you custom order, you might have some that are an Avery Dennison film, or possibly others. But they all have the control tack on them, which is going to make it easier for the installation. And also another great thing about this film is that if you do, if you make a wrinkle in the film, all you have to do, if you've got a heat gun or a hair dryer, you'll be able to use that heat gun or the hair dryer to get that wrinkle out of the film. So that way it's not a permanent problem, but it's something that's completely fixable. Also, you want to make sure this is nice and dry before you install it. Some places will try to install film wet. You don't want to do it on this. The 1080 film is not designed for that. And all you're going to do is end up making a mess later on. So even though there's a little bit of damage on here, this should cover it up fine. If you've got a lot of damage where it's been beat up, you might want to take like a real fine sandpaper, like a 1500 grit, or maybe even an 800 grit, sand it down, and then use a 1500 over it to get rid of some of the blemishes. That blemish is really insignificant, so it's not that big of a deal. So this top piece, first thing we'll do is we're going to grab this top piece. You just want to be careful how much you touch it as well. You don't want to touch it a ton, just because the more you touch it, the greater the chance of getting particles underneath it. Now what we're going to do, we're just going to lay this right on top. And all you're doing is just eyeballing it, lining things up to where everything looks like it's all right. I just thumbtack it down. Everything looks good where it is. Start from the center, out one way, out the other, out a third, and a fourth, and just work it out to the edges. You don't ever want to work it in, because then you're going to end up with a big bubble here in the middle. So just work your way out. It's as easy as that. You can give it a wipe down afterwards. You're going to end up with some fingerprints on here. This is the satin black film that we're using. I suggest the satin black or the satin colors versus the matte colors. The matte colors will tend to scratch easier, where this will tend to look better for a longer period of time. So simple as that. We got the top piece on. I'll show you some of these other pieces that we got on here. Some of these smaller pieces. Again, a lot of this is going to be a matter of just doing a good job lining these pieces up. And see, it's nice enough, it's actually touching and it can slide until you tack it down. And once you tack it down, then it's gonna maintain its position pretty well. Put just a little tiny tack on there, make sure it looks good where it is, where I want it. Squeegee it down. There we go. slide this around, we'll get another end piece on. And again, a lot of this is just lining it up. Get it lined up from top to bottom, left to right, wherever you like it. And some of these smaller pieces you can even kind of tack down with your thumb. Give it a quick little wipe. And the reason I just wipe it down after each one, just to make sure I like how it looks. You don't have to wipe each piece down because you're going to end up getting more fingerprints and stuff on it. So that's just a matter of your own personal choice what you want to do. I'm going to bring it around some more. We're going to get this other top piece. And I like to just work from the top down. And on this particular set, the customer wants to get the reflective vinyl for the vertical corners. So we're gonna end up putting a black a black reflective tape on the vertical edges of all three of the panniers. So we're gonna come back up to this front piece. Now this front piece, you've got the recessed BMW right here. When we're doing the installation on this, I'll show you what we'll do. When we go over that, you're gonna wanna take your finger and rub that in, because again, with a control tack, it's got air channels for air release underneath. So you'll be able to get that out without leaving any bubbles in there. So we're gonna lay it down. And one of the things you want to try to avoid is letting the film touch on itself. That can cause much greater problems that are a little bit harder to reverse. Not impossible to reverse, but certainly a little bit tougher to reverse. Start the center, work up, work down, work right, and work left. Now, right here where the BMW is, you can either use your finger, press down in those B's to get that air out. Just kind of work your fingers around it, up and down. Put a decent amount of pressure. You don't want to put too much pressure on there that you're going to wrinkle a film. And kind of work the vinyl with your squeegee a little bit also while you're doing it. I don't know if you can see in here where you can see some of that reflection from that BMW. And we're going to work our way up. Work our way up and out. Again, don't ever work toward the middle. You want to work yourself out toward the corners. So I don't know if you can see that reflection where that BMW is, so it's all recessed in where it should be. Next, we'll come up to one of these end pieces here. on it. Again. We've got the ability to move it around as we need until we get it where we like it. Let it rest on there. That side. Spin it around. Next, we're going to get this other side. We've got a cutout there for the locking mechanism. Now there's also, if you've got some of the older panniers, you can still use this kit. Some of the older panniers have got, the locking mechanisms are a little bit thinner. So you're gonna have a little bit more of the metal showing through. But as far as the tops and the sides, you know, a lot of the front and back pieces and stuff, a lot of those are still very similar in size and shape, so it's not going to make that much of a difference. And some of them you can actually adjust a little bit to fit it better. So just because you don't have these newer panniers, and I've also got some patterns for for like the 800s, for some of the other sets that we're also going to be posting online. So don't be discouraged if you don't have a 1200 or, and again, even for the 800s, for the panniers that are on the 800s, these, you know, fit accordingly with some minor trimming to them or some minor adjustments to them. So you can still get a good clean look on your pannier or your luggage. All right, so the only thing that we would have left to do now is do these vertical edges, and we're going to be doing those with the reflective black vinyl. I've still got to cut those, but those essentially go on the same way. I'll use a piece here. And the reflective black kits are available also online if you choose to get those. So this way you get the look, that coverage around there. Now see, I don't know if you can see down there, there's a little bit of a wrinkle in there. All we'd have to do to take care of that, you're gonna wanna lift that up a little bit, lift it up beyond where the wrinkle is. Then you can take your heat gun, get your heat gun warm. Just leave it on there for a few seconds and you can watch it disappear. Simple as that. And then next time you're going down, just be a little bit more careful. And that's what the side vertical pieces look like. So that's the installation on those. So here's your BMW panniers. And again, we've got several colors available. Most common and most popular is the satin black. But if you want custom colors, you can just give us a call, 828-676-3030 or 828-702-2405. Again, it's Auto Armor of Asheville, and we are working with Eurosport Asheville on this program to get those panniers covered for you guys. Have a great day.